there is up in the sky information pollution, and the polluters are trying to deflect blame. Dishonest cries of censorship are filling Fox's airwaves with charges that these guys right here are being suppressed. The word censorship's been invoked almost 400 times on Fox this month alone, and more than 300 times on Newsmax. You know, post-insurrection, a book publisher decided that it did not want to be in business with Senator Josh Hawley. So he's been on a national TV tour claiming he's muzzled. And Tucker Carlson is telling viewers that this network, CNN, is trying to force Fox News off the air, which is patently false. It's as predictable as the sunrise. Democrats win elections, and then Republicans say they are being silenced. But while some cry cancel culture, let me suggest a different way to think about this. A harm reduction model. Most people want clean air and blue skies and accurate news and rational views. And then in that healthy environment that looks beautiful, then we can have great fights about taxes and regulation and healthcare and all the rest. The vast majority of people can agree that disinformation about, let's say, the pandemic is unhealthy. It's harmful. So how can that harm be reduced? Well, big tech platforms say they are removing lies about vaccines and stamping out Stop the Steal BS and QAnon cult content. Now, do these private companies have too much power? Sure, and many people would say yes, of course they do. But reducing a liar's reach is not the same as censoring freedom of speech. Freedom of speech is different than freedom of reach. And algorithmic reach is part of the problem. Now, Facebook CEO Mark Zuckerberg seems to agree. Here's the headline from Politico. He's pledging to depoliticize Facebook. Zuckerberg says one of the top pieces of feedback that we're hearing from our community is that people don't want politics and fighting to take over their experience on our services. Well, he's several years too late, but that is a real issue. And he wants to now try to clean up Facebook. But this is bigger than Facebook. This harm happens all over the place. In the words of a recently fired Fox News editor, news consumers are both overfed and malnourished at the same time, gorging on empty informational calories, indulging their sugar fixes of self-affirming half-truths and even outright lies. It's impossible to make all those lies go away, but they can be reduced. All right? Harm reduction. But instead we get this over on Newsmax. Look at this, Biden's plan to destroy America. It looks like some crazy comic book movie or something, or some action hero movie. That's what we get on Newsmax. Here's what we get on Fox. Tucker Carlson declaring that unity for Dems means locking up their opponents and, quote, you can now be arrested for saying the wrong thing. What? And the government is at war with its own people. What? This apocalyptic stuff is day in, day out on these channels. It is part of a radicalization pipeline that pits neighbors against neighbor and lets fear overpower courage. And it poisons American politics. To borrow the pollution metaphor again, the people who live closest to the factory, who ingest most of the pollution, they get the sickest. But everyone is affected by this toxic information world. So most of the criticism of Facebook is not aimed at stopping social media, stamping it out. It's about making the platform actually more social, helping friendships, not ruining them. And most of the criticism of Fox News is not aimed at shutting it down, which will never happen anyway. It's about making Fox better, putting the news back in Fox News. They could go the other way. If Fox is going to keep transitioning into the 24/7 Tucker channel, then maybe it belongs next to sci-fi on your channel lineup, not MSNBC. These need to be nuanced conversations, not edicts, not orders. This is complicated, but harm reduction is possible. Harm reduction is possible by adding more news and less opinion to the content. Harm reduction is possible by pushing some of the QAnon craziness out of your newsfeed on Facebook. This is not ultimately about freedom of speech. It's about freedom of reach. And with me now is someone who's thought a lot about this, Nick Kristof. He's the author and New York Times columnist who recently penned a letter to my conservative friends. I had some really important messages in this column, Nick, so thanks for coming on and talking about it.
I'm delighted.
You've been saying a lot lately about Fox, and I'm interested in hearing it. What overall is the message that you believe right-wing, Trump voters are hearing from their media outlets of choice, and how are those messages deceiving them?
Well, Brian, I'm speaking to you right now from the family farm I grew up on in rural Oregon. And, you know, I have a lot of pro-Trump friends here who are glued to Fox. And it's been really sad to see them absorb a message that the coronavirus is nothing serious, that masks don't work, that Trump won re-election, that the big danger is from Antifa rather than the right. And, you know, I believe in diversity of opinion as much as anybody. I believe we need a marketplace of ideas, but we all know that there are red lines. We wouldn't let a KKK grand wizard preach racism, divisiveness on a cable channel. And it seems to me that Fox and OAN and Newsmax have genuinely cost lives with the way they've reported, quote unquote, the pandemic. And, you know, I think that red line needs to be drawn in a way that will minimize the kind of damage that I see here and that we've seen nationwide. It's not about censorship today.
On the pandemic, we're at the last day of January. This is the deadliest month of the pandemic in America thus far. There are some signs that we're trending in the right direction, starting to come down from those awful high levels of hospitalizations. But this month, this has been the worst month yet in the pandemic. And yet that story is not frequently told from these pro-Trump right-wing sources. And they are still very much pro-Trump. I know Trump is the former president, but these outlets are still more Trumpy than they are Republican. And I think that's an important distinction. You wrote in your column that you feel like a lot of folks are being deceived by these outlets, that they're being conned. So you're saying the profit model is part of the problem, right?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, look, I had friends here who reached out to me because they were concerned after watching Fox that they were going to be locked up in re-education camps for supporting Trump. And, you know, at one level, that was ridiculous, but it also pained me. And, you know, this is the kind of thing that led Ashley Babbitt to go and invade the Capitol and get shot. And it's what leads Fox viewers to disdain masks, to avoid vaccination. You know, I think we recognize that if a major network were encouraging people to drink arsenic to improve their complexion, then advertisers would desert that network and cable companies wouldn't carry that network. And it feels to me as if some of the extreme right-wing media organizations are doing something very similar.
Fox News is definitely the Trump administration in exile now. Stephen Miller all over the channel. They just hired Larry Kudlow. They're in talks with Kayleigh McEnany. Your message in your column is that people shouldn't be forced to subsidize Fox News in their basic cable packages. Now, Tucker will say you're trying to destroy the channel. What are you actually arguing?
You know, I'm trying to save a right-wing opposition, which we need to keep us honest. And, you know, I'm progressive. I think it's really important that there are sensible right-wing critics who hold my feet to the fire, who will disagree with me. But that doesn't mean that we need extremists who are preaching things that end up killing people. And at the end of the day, it also strikes me as deeply offensive when we all buy products that then support that kind of hatred and disinformation. And when we have to pay, as you say, for cable packages that then subsidize companies that are doing a lot of damage, mostly to their own audience, but to some degree to the country as a whole.
I got to tell you, the sources I have at Fox, they are concerned about the extremist content on that network. They are worried about it just like you are. So you're far from the only one.